Okay.
My question is this. We need to have a good leader. So from the beginning, which I have grown up in the village, I didn't have a good teacher. Like my mom, actually, a followers of him. So I used to ask in the past, why do you like him? She had an answer. He likes to stand for the rights. And I asked her, what kind of rights he stands for? He said, he treat people fairly and he must be wise always. He is always a wise person. And now how do you answer that? I took him as my leader. And I found out now I'm in the right place to go. I need a leader like him. So what we need? So we need the right teacher like him. So mostly youths are always with their phones. So media is like a good platform actually. They misuse. They don't like politics. I used to be like that. I like to go for vote. And I used to choose him. I know he will win one day. But it takes my... Yeah, I know he will achieve, but it will take a long term because a lot of politics, which has already been like a rubbish band, you know. We already been in the rubbish bands, but we do not know. So we have to collect and find out. So can you please, sir, can you please explain to us, how do you look for a good teacher like you? Can you please explain to us?
Thank you.
Yeah.
And first, my regards to your mother. We must find better example than Anwar. I'm sure there are many, and we will have to strive to remind. But I think for the youth, it is important, incumbent, that you inculcate this understanding, this measure of tolerance, humanity, and then interact with the rest. How do you do that? You do that by having these small discussions, groups, continue to explain, use your social media, at least to your family circles. Everyone has their own family. So I mean, they're talking about chuchu and whatever, you know, family issues. But you can always impart a little knowledge in that. I remember meeting one student years back, from University of Malaya, who came after my ceramah in somewhere in Ampang. He said to me, sir, I have a problem. I said, what? My parents just cannot accept anything else but UMNO. So what do I do? And so I said, number one, love them, okay? And respect them. They are good people. But they don't get that understanding of the other view. So what do? You bring back suara keadilan and just leave it in the house. And I tell you, at first the father just ignored. But after some month, when he went back to the holidays, this was in Johor, the father said, you didn't bring back suara keadilan? You see, so don't blame them. No, my parents were all hardcore UMNO members because in my village we don't know anything else. There's no other opposition party. The only party there was UMNO. And my father was a member of parliament those days, and my mother was Ketua Wanita UMNO. So in the village and the whole area, I don't know about any other party. But when you get to the university, you start being critical. Then, well, I was very fortunate because they supported me and they left UMNO before now both of them died. And I'm very blessed. But the patience, you should never doubt or compromise the fact that you must love them dearly for whatever their view may be that you either agree or disagree. That affection will be recognized. So you ask me, first on the, in relation with the parents, second, how do you inculcate good leadership? Then you have to do it from young. You know, people talk about principles, values, but there's no integrity. I've seen so many who are blatantly corrupt by getting, even in our PH government at that time, you must remember the flaws in this flow. That's why they are easily enticed, because of the projects, because of the position. So they left. I mean, some people have been with us for years, but could not resist this enticement in terms of funds and position. Jadi sebab itu kita, kalau untuk anak muda, kita kena ingat, ia tidak mudah. Ada seorang penceramah dari, sekarang ini SPRM, dulu BPR, datang ke Universiti Melaya. Saya tahun 2 Universiti Melaya. Dia syarah. Susah menentang rasuah. Ya, kita lawan. Okey. Baik. Sekarang saya setuju. Anak mahasiswa semua menentang rasuah. Sebab, saudara tak ada peluang ambil rasuah. So, dia menentang. Kemudian dia kata, saudara kebanyakannya akan jadi penolong pegawai daerah. Masa itu kan kebanyakan pelajar mahasiswa Melayu akan jadi, will enter the civil service. Dan pegawai daerah atau berguru. Baik, bila jadi pegawai daerah, datang seorang peniaga, minta apa, lesen, bagi RM500. You nanti saudara punya reaction akan jadi, jangan, saya kerja ikut peraturan dan prinsip. Baik. Bulan depan dia datang lagi, bagi RM1,000. Dia kata, jawab dia lain sikit. Tak usah, you know, I do my work. You don't need to bother these things. Okay. Bulan satu lagi datang, RM5,000. Okay lah, no, this time ni, lain kali jangan. Sudah. So, dia cerita tentang pengalaman dia dengan teman-teman dia dalam kerajaan. So, itu juga ada peringatan. Saya tengok kadang-kadang anak muda ni, ada yang semangat, bagus. Ada kesedaran, bagus. Tapi kadang-kadang ada kurang tawaduknya, kurang humility-nya. Dia anggap dia tahu semua, terpandai semua, dan orang semua kata, ya, itu bermasalah. Sebab itu saya kata, didikan moral, ethics atau akhlak itu juga penting. Ini sekali lagi saya ucap terima kasih.